In this video, we are going to learn about the two-way valve and three-way valve. In the last video, we saw about PICV. This video is the continuation of that. We saw in the last video that when the room temperature reaches the set point, the PICV closes and the water flow stops in the cooling coil. After the PICV is closed, the pressure in the pipeline increases as the pump continues to run. We are going to see how the increased pressure is controlled by two-way valve and three-way valve. Two-way valve is a valve with one inlet and one outlet. If the valve closes, the water flow will stop. When the valve is open, water starts to flow again. Three-way valve is a valve having two inlet and one outlet, or two outlet and one inlet. In a three-way valve with one inlet and two outlets, one outlet is closed, while the other outlet is open. When you close an open outlet, the closed outlet will open. In a three-way valve with two inlets and one inlet is closed, while the other inlet is open. When the open inlet is closed, the closed inlet will open. This is the difference between two-way valve and three-way valve. Let's take three rooms and take one AHU for each room and three pumps. Now let's install two-way valve in AHU. The pumps are sending water from the chiller to the AHUs. Let us take its pressure in the pipeline as 10 bars. Now, if the temperature of a room reaches the set point, the PICV will close in the AHU of that room. As a two-way valve is installed in the PICV, the water going to the AHU stops. As the pumps continue to send water, even after the valve is closed, the pressure in the pipeline increases. When the pressure in the pipeline increases, the pressure sensor installed in the pipeline sends a signal to the VFD of the pump. Then the VFD will reduce the speed of the pump according to the pressure and maintain the pressure of 10 bars in the pipeline. If two-way valve is used in AHU, VFD is used in pumps. Because when the two-way valve is open and close, the speed of the pump should be increased or decreased through the VFD. By this, a constant pressure can be maintained in the pipeline. Now, let's install the three-way valve in the AHU. First, let us see in which condition three-way valve is used. If the pumps are directly driven by electricity, without the use of a VFD, then three-way valve is used. If the pumps are driven directly by electricity, the speed of the pump cannot be increased or decreased. It runs at constant speed only. We have talked about the basic structure of three-way valve. There are two types of three-way valve. One is a valve with one inlet and two outlets, and the other is a valve with two inlets and one outlet. But in AHU, the valve with two inlets and one outlet is used. Let's see how it works. Let's install a three-way valve with two inlets and one outlet. The outlet of the three-way valve is connected to the return line. One inlet is connected to the outlet of the cooling coil, and another inlet is connected to the supply line. When the room temperature reaches the set point, the PICV closes. As we have already said, if one inlet closes, another inlet will open. So, the water coming from the cooling coil stops, and no more water comes inside the cooling coil. The water coming from the supply line goes directly to the return line through another inlet. Due to this, the flow in the pipeline will continue. Pressure also does not increase. Thus, there is no need to change the speed of the pump. This is the detailed explanation of two-way valve and three-way valve. Support our channel by joining our channel and becoming a member. Once a month, video will be published from topics given by members. If you have any doubt, ask in comments section. If the video is useful, then like the video and share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe and support to our Zebra Learnings channel. Thank you.